Hello again, brothers and sisters in Christ. Let's see, this is Thursday, March the 19th, and now it's 8:44 p.m., and I want to share two short videos. This one is by J.D. Farag, and some of you may already follow him. Somebody did send me this one in an email, even though... let's see, am I still subscribed to him? No, I got unsubscribed. That happens all the time. I don't know, I unsubscribed to some people, but I don't think I unsubscribed to him. I like J.D. Farag. He is a pastor in Hawaii. Now, this is only a 6-minute, 50-second video, so I guess, and he's making it from home, it looks like, or maybe that's a library at church, his church, but I don't know if there's, most of the churches are not meeting at right now, but anyway, let's take a listen to his take on this coronavirus. This is really good. Just listen to him.
Aloha. I wanted to do a quick coronavirus update and in so doing tackle two tough questions. The first of which is there an agenda with this coronavirus? Well, according to one MIT biologist, yes, there is. Last Thursday, March 12th, there was an article posted online in which MIT scientist and biologist Dr. Shiva, and I sure hope I'm pronouncing his last name correctly, Ayadurai, responded to a tweet from U.S. President Donald Trump saying, and I quote, this is the tweet, as an MIT PhD in biological engineering who studies and does research nearly every day on the immune system, the hashtag coronavirus fear-mongering by the deep state will go down in history as one of the biggest frauds to manipulate economies, suppress dissent, and push mandated medicine. So, back to our question, is there an agenda? Answer, well, it's my personal belief that if there is an agenda, and there very well could be, it really doesn't matter, and I'll explain why. This for two reasons. First, God overrules all and rules over all. And secondly, as believers in and followers of Jesus Christ, we know how this ends, which brings me to the second question, which is this the end? Well, yesterday...
Well, I'm going to stop it there, but it's 6 minutes and 50 seconds worth your time, and I could go ahead and play the whole thing, but you're looking at me, not him, and he deserves the credit. But what the man he had was talking about, saying this was some kind of an agenda, or there was an agenda behind it, I totally agree. I don't want to say there's no real virus and that people aren't really getting sick and dying because 20,000 died of the influenza flu last year. But the way they're hyping it up and closing everything, I mean, they don't do that for the regular flu. They just want to give you a flu shot, and half the people who take it, or I don't know the statistics, but I know this, a lot of people still get the flu anyway. And then the doctors claim, well, at least they get a lesser case of it. Well, maybe they do. Okay, now this other one is only a minute and a half, so I'm going to play this for you, and it is from Steve Fletcher.
Forced vaccination law has been passed in Denmark. Denmark passes law enabling forced coronavirus vaccinations.
Now, see, this really surprised me because I had heard in a previous video that it was going to take till 2021 to even make a coronavirus. So what are they injecting into these people?
article coming out on March 17th, 2020. Law was passed on Thursday, March 12th, 2020. Denmark has passed an emergency law that allows for the government to force people to take a vaccine for coronavirus. The emergency law gives authorities sweeping powers to tackle the COVID-19 pandemic and will remain in force until March 2021. Citizens who refuse to be tested for the coronavirus will face fines and potential prison time and will be prevented from entering shops, grocery stores, public institutions, and hospitals, while also being restricted from using public transport.
Who refuse to be tested? If you're just perfectly fine, normal, living your life, Denver decides everybody has to be tested? Man, they're going way overboard. There's something to it.
As well as enforcing quarantine measures, the law also allows the authorities to force people to be vaccinated, even though there is currently no vaccination for the virus. Copenhagen University law professor Jens Ilo-Ritter said the new law measures were certainly the most extreme since the Second World War. The initial draft of the law was even more draconian and would have allowed police to enter private homes without a warrant if there was a suspicion of a coronavirus infection.
And how would that happen? Unless you had a neighbor, a serviceman of some kind, a postman, and he heard you sneeze, and you had to blow your nose, and you maybe coughed a little. I mean, seriously, this is so getting out of hand, it's ridiculous. I'm all for taking the precautions, coughing in your sleeve, being, I don't know. And then we got the problem with the youth thinking they're, oh, we're healthy. We're not letting, how did he put it? We're not letting this virus keep us from partying. Because, you know, it's spring break. Well, here in Alabama, we had enough cases of people turning positive on this test. There aren't that many down south, but there's enough where they closed the beaches because the youth don't want to stay off of them because it's spring break. It's time to party hardy, you know? And they don't even care who they're going to go home to or could go home to getting it themselves. They think they're invincible. So our state, I applaud them because that's a lot of money lost to shut down the beaches for spring break. That's probably their biggest week, the weeks, because different schools will shut down 1 week and the colleges, different colleges shut down different weeks. So it's like 3 weeks of spring break down there. And I'm sure they're going to lose a lot of money for that, but they're doing the right thing, I guess. They believe, see, everybody like here where I live, they're made to believe this thing is so deadly, you know, especially for older folks or people that are already sick with something. If they get it, they're gonna die, you know. That it will be really hard on them and there aren't enough ventilators in the hospitals if we reach that peak that, like, Wuhan, China had. You know, like, one day there's one, the next day there's 10, the next day there's so many, and the next day there's so many, and they're going by a projected amount of people. That's why they're shutting everything down. Our little local restaurant right around the corner, just takeout only. Everything is takeout only. And they've shut all transportation down for this place. If you have a doctor's appointment, you're supposed to cancel it. If it's not, you know, urgent. If it's like a checkup or something. And that appointment I was supposed to have, I was supposed to go Monday. I didn't even know it. Nobody told me that I was supposed to see hematology Monday. And they called to tell me not to come because the nurse practitioner I was supposed to see didn't even come in. Probably because all the schools here have closed. They closed the school Sunday night. They made the decision and texted all the parents. Schools are closed from now until April 15th or something. I don't know. It could be indefinitely until they decide. See how it goes, you know. Well, anyway, I've rambled long enough. And I'll put the links to these two videos in the description box if you want to watch this one from Steve Fletcher again. If you want to hear it again, and by the way, the source of this, where he got this is Zero Hedge. I've been thinking about resubscribing to them and getting their articles myself. They seem to have some good, solid stuff. I mean, why make a law? They've made the law in Denmark to go ahead and enforce vaccination before vaccination is even made. It's something's just behind this. This is just practice in crowd control. It's just my opinion. Stay well, everybody, okay? I'll plead the blood of Jesus over this video, the internet connection, myself, my computer, and all of you and your devices and your internet connections as well, so we can stay connected. And with that, I will say bye for now. I will talk to you later.